YouTube, what's up? Welcome to my garage, and today I have some knowledge for you in Endless. So a couple of days ago, I made a video about Classic, right? And today we're gonna do a video about Endless. This is gonna be a mini series in a couple of episodes, and we're gonna learn about just, I would say, Endless overall. I am on my fifth run right now. I have completed three of them, and the other one was stopped at like 3k or something. So I have some experience and I'm gonna teach you how to play during Endless and how to complete your first run. This is why today we are gonna play with low cost only. We are gonna play with 4 cost and below only. You're gonna see it's actually pretty easy to find 4 cost to carry your team. Of course, I'm gonna give you some options, like 1 or 2 options at the beginning, because we are pretty limited, of course. But here you go. So that's gonna be it. Please subscribe if you want to see more and let me know in the comments as well. I will see you all in the next one. So, before we start, I know people are gonna recommend Tinkaton or whatever. Obviously, if you go Tinkaton with huge power, you need to farm it and just go for it. It works. You can fuse Tinkaton with something else, like a Rookie D, for example. He has Unnerve, right? So you can fix those two together and you have a huge power unnerve, pretty strong, and like Pokemon overall. This is gonna be obviously one of your choices for carries, probably something you need to farm though. I'm gonna go with flinching. I always wanted to play flinching strats, so I'm gonna play flinching, okay? We are gonna play Gyarados, Shellder. Now Shellder is gonna be my main carry early on because Magikarp sucks, right? And I am going to go with Water Shuriken, Skill Link, Shellder. If you have it, you can go for it, right? The point is, for early game in Endless, you want to have something that can carry you the first 50 floors to carry your second carry, like quote-unquote second carry, right? Like the door into Gyarados, right? So Gyarados is actually my first carry, and then I'm gonna have a second carry later on. Shellder is just here to help early on, and then it's gonna switch into another role. He's gonna switch into a flinch role later on. So his goal is gonna be to only flinch with Water Shuriken, Multilens, King's Rock, and all that jazz. First Pokemon, Shellder, Skill Link. Obviously for you, it can be different if you pick a different carry. You can pick Meowth. To be honest, it's pretty okay because he has Fake Out, right? And Fake Out can be used as a flinching support, so you can use Meowth as a early carry. He has Payday as well, so it's pretty great. And then you can switch him into a Fake Out support later on, just like Shellder. This is the main carry early on with flinch support later on. My first carry is gonna be a flinching Gyarados. I always wanted to play it. I'm gonna actually pick the shiny here because I like the red Gyarados. And I'm just gonna go Adamant. There you go. So I'm gonna take into account that you have no reduction cost or anything, right? But you still have like some egg moves left and right. So you can choose a Pokemon to carry you early on, or you can use Technician Meowth. Next, so Pokerus or not. In this specific case, and in this specific case only, if you have a low cost Pokerus available and something that's gonna be useful for your team later on, you can pick a Pokerus. Do not pick Pokerus if you need the slot in your team. Like, don't use Pokerus. Simple. Pokerus is basically 2 XP charms. That's all it is. It's nothing. Alright? If the Pokerus that you choose is gonna be useful for you later on, and it's a low cost, go for it. But don't go for a 5 cost. Like, don't go for the baby Snorlax. Like, it's a slot for nothing. Alright? But in this specific case, Petilil is actually gonna turn into my second carry later on. So that's why in this case here, I can actually choose to go for her. Alright? I'm gonna go with Timid for the nature. Alright. So now we have Lily Petilil. That's a 3 cost. I'm not taking into account reduction cost here. We have Shellder, that's 4. Magikarp is 3, so that's 7 plus 3, 10. I'm gonna go with Ghastly as well. It's gonna be useful later on. the nature doesn't matter because I'm gonna turn him into a support prankster later on with stuff like Soak, Curse, Gastro Acid, and Disable. That's gonna be the play. I'm gonna explain as we go the dangers into Endless, but you have multi-hit Pokemons, and because we're gonna run a sturdy Pokemon in the second part of the game, we want to take into account those dangers, like multi-hit Pokemons or stuff like Mold Breaker that can go through sturdy. So we want to take Disable for multi-hit moves, and we take Gastro Acid to remove those abilities. And we do all of this on the Prankster Pokemon, so they go always first. And if they don't have Mold Breaker or a multi-hit move, we can go for something like Curse and Soak to just help us win faster, basically. Alright? So that's why I picked Ghastly here. Ghastly is the best choice for Curse things or Disable or stuff like that. It's a great Pokemon. And just, I guess Gengar is just a good Pokemon early on as well, if you have the Mega Evolution and stuff like that. So Ghastly is a 3 cost. So now we have 4 plus 3, 7, plus 3, 10, plus 3, that's 13. We need 2 Pokemons. So I would say at that point, you might have some cost reduction for very easy Pokemon to get. Like Rattata, you probably have one reduction. And you might have one reduction for... you need one cost reduction for Rattata or Zigzagoon. Just farm it for one of them, or you probably have it already. So Rattata is 1 and Zigzagoon is 2. So I don't have enough points here, but if you reduce cost for Zigzagoon once, you actually have enough. So I'm gonna go with Zigzagoon here. So the problem with my shinies here is that even if I remove the shiny, right, I'm still gonna get the luck anyways. So I'm gonna show you, I'm gonna remove the shiny, you can actually see it now. I'm still gonna go into the game, and I'm gonna take Rattata, I'm gonna remove the shiny as well. You will see, when I get into the game, I'm still gonna get the luck even if I remove my shiny status here. So I can't really remove my luck from those Pokemons. I mean, the best case would be to go on a new account, but I'm not doing that. It's not happening. So there you go, that's the team. Shellder, Magikarp, Petilil, Ghastly, Zigzagoon, Rattata. Alright, so before we go, I wanted to explain that the order of the Pokemons actually matter here because we want to have the Pokerus at the second position. Because the Pokerus spreads in terms of turns, and it spreads to nearly Pokemon, like near Pokemons, right? So if I have it on the second spot, it's gonna spread to my first Pokemon, my carry, at the beginning. So you want to have the order correctly. So again, I'm gonna redo the team really quick. I'm gonna have Shellder with Adamant and Skill Link. Then I'm gonna go for the Pokerus if you choose to have it. So I'm gonna go with Petilil here. There you go, second spot, right? Remember? Then we're gonna go for the third spot, that's my main carry. So I'm gonna put Petilil between Shellder and Gyarados, basically. That's the goal here. Then we are gonna select what we selected earlier, so I'm removing the shiny just to show you after that. We are gonna go with Rattata, Zigzagoon, and Ghastly, right? Alright, so now that we are in, it is very important that I show you that, again, the fact that I removed the shiny doesn't matter. See, this is a non-shiny Rattata, but I still have the luck. Same for Zigzagoon. I actually removed my shiny, but I still have the luck. So if you remove the shiny, you don't lose the luck. So there is really nothing I can do for the luck. Alright, so, again, we have Petilil in between. It's gonna spread the Pokerus to Magikarp and Shellder very early on. Alright, so... Basically, before floor 5, we're gonna have access to the Pokerus on Shellder. So what are we looking early on? We are gonna reroll the first 10 floors every time we can to look for XP charms. XP charms are gonna be very important because we want to have that extra XP. So we have Pokerus and we want to look for at least 2 XP charms. That way, we are gonna be very far away in experience every single time. We have very weak Pokemons, so when we're gonna get to like floor 40 or floor 35, we are gonna start meeting like very tough Pokemons to beat, alright? So in that fashion, we need to look for those specific items. I'm gonna go for the Calcium here. Doesn't really matter, to be honest. I'm still gonna go for Water Shuriken, there you go. So don't forget, just reroll, use your money, use the candies, I'm gonna use it on Shellder. That's the early game carry. So if you don't have XP charm or candies, go for lures. We want to have, as I said, as much EXP as we can early on. Alright, so lures, candies, XP charms. That's the goal early on. Okay, so as you can see, we have the Pokérus on Shellder now, we have it on Petilil, and we have it on Magikarp. And we're starting to have it on the other Pokémons as well. But basically, it spread to Shellder very early on, like Floor 4, Floor 3. Just so we can get that Pokérus very early on. So I'm gonna take a lure again. If you have 3 lures, you get Perma Double Battle, which is what we want here. So after floor 10, you get your first XP ult and your first super XP charm. This is what we are looking for here. We are looking for extra XP charm and super XP charm. Basically, the Pokérus is just a bad XP charm, but it is still one. So we have one XP charm right now, which is the Pokérus. We do have the XP charm from the floor 10. We want more of that. We want more XP charms, more candies, more double battles. This is what we are looking for here. Alright, so as you can see, we have 3 lures and we have a max lure now. What we want is, again, more EXP. We are looking for those lures. Don't be afraid to get them because we do need that EXP. If you can get a water stone, that would be great as well. Okay, so we got lucky here. We have a super EXP charm, so again, more EXP. That's great. Yeah, we might need to skip this one. So if you have a battle you can't win, just go on Rattata and run away. In this case, floor 20. A Sun Flamethrower with that kind of Pokemon, we can't really deal with it. So we have to skip it. Sadly. We do. It do be like that, I guess. So you're aiming. We got 2 XP charms. So we are actually good on that specific aspect. But we are missing... since we ran at floor 20, we actually lost an XP charm, right? This is the bad thing about running at the end of the floor. You don't get the reward for it. And that's why I didn't want to run. I actually tried to kill him, but I probably can't kill him. That's why I ran here. So we lost the XP charm, which is actually bad. But we got an extra one, so we should be okay. We might not be able to kill this once again, so we are losing the XP charm at the end. This is very annoying that we got those kinds of Pokemons, but I mean, we can try, but I'm missing as well. That's not the thing here. This is definitely doable if I don't miss. There you go. Okay, so this was doable, but sometimes you have some very tough enemies. So Aura Beam, we don't really need it. I guess it could be good for early on, so I'm gonna replace Water Gun, but... Don't really need it, to be honest. Okay, so see, we got the XP charm now because we won the floor. We have an XP charm. So every time you beat a floor, you have the XP charm or like a super XP charm. But if you move away, like if you go away, you don't actually get the charm, which is the issue actually if you run away too much. Okay, so we have Gyarados now. Now, do we switch permanently into Gyarados? Not really. We're gonna stay a bit on Cloyster for a while. And we are gonna move. So Learn Bite, very important. So we have Ice Spinner and Liquidation. So of course, we can go into Gyarados now. But I mean, you might not have those egg moves. So I'm gonna stay on Shellder a bit longer. but the play here is definitely to switch on Gyarados. Now, I guess if the play is to switch on Gyarados, I should probably switch right now, because that's what I'm saying. So, do I switch now? I guess I could keep Shellder as a support for double battles. Okay, I'm switching to Gyarados. That's definitely the play here. We're just gonna spam Spite or Liquidation. It should kill most of the time. It's a lot of damage. For sure. Gyarados is a pretty strong Pokemon. Waterfall is great as well. It can flinch, so it's definitely better than Liquidation. I'm gonna remove Liquidation here. Or Flip Turn, actually. Let's remove Flip Turn for now. Waterstone, so again, great. We can evolve Shellder. So now we have a Cluster and a Gyarados. That's gonna be great for double battles. We're gonna kill everything very fast. That's actually great. And Cluster actually learns Icicle Spear, which is a 5-turn move as well. So we're gonna replace... in that case, I'm gonna replace Aurora Beam. There you go. So if we have a double battle, that's gonna be great. We want to level him as much as we can now. So we have Curse on Ghastly, right? We're gonna learn it instead of Frost Breath, it doesn't matter over there, but that's how we're gonna use Curse. It's actually very important here. So do you want to relearn anything that we missed? Not really. I guess we could learn Ice Fang instead of Ice Spinner. I don't know if there is a big difference we can actually check. Ice Fang is like 65. It can make the target flinch, so it is great. We can have it instead of Ice Spinner. But, you know, it's the power and the accuracy. We can relearn Ice Fang later. I just wanted to check to make sure, but we can relearn Ice Fang later on. I'm gonna remove Liquidation for Rain Dance. This way we have... we have a weather move we can use at the beginning. And keep Amulet Coin, very important item as well for money. I'm gonna use Rain Dance right now. So we have it for the floor boss. And I'm gonna Waterfall. So again, for double battle, we want Cluster and Gyarados. That's what we're using. So I'm gonna do Waterfall on one. And I guess Water Shuriken on the other. Alright, so now we have 50. This is a crucial point if you have weak Pokemons. It's gonna be a very hard set of floors until 250s when you are like starting to have some items. I'm gonna try to do something here. We'll see if we can win. We can't really heal, we don't really have money. So we're gonna go in the fight like this. I'm just gonna revive Cluster. Let's see what we have. Iron Hands, alright. So I'm gonna try to curse. Let's see if we can do it. We are faster, so he has the curse. That's good. Now, I'm gonna go into Cluster. I'm gonna click some priority move on him with Water Shuriken, so we can remove a couple of bars. We're not dying. I'm just gonna finish him off. Because, like, EXP doesn't matter on Gyarados right now, because we are at the level cap, right? So, like, getting XP on Gyarados doesn't matter right now. And he has Thunder too, so it's even worse. So in that specific case here, winning on Cloyster is actually okay because we are getting to the level cap too. And we get the XP charms. And we get the voucher. Water Shuriken on the sturdy Pokemon, right? That potentially has sturdy, and then Waterfall on the guy that doesn't have sturdy here. That's why we have Water Shuriken as well, right? Multi-hit move against sturdy, it's just very strong. We have 4 lures. We got one lure every single turn. So we are actually sure to have double battles now. That's actually nice. We want to have that EXP advantage. That's what we want. Be ahead in levels. Get those XP charms. Get those candies. I can't say it enough. You need to have EXP. Alright, Petit Lil Evolution. So, to get the other version of Lilligant, you want to do it during the day or at dawn. To be honest, we don't really care about special attack or attack. Petit Lil is only gonna be used for dots later on. So what we have here is completely irrelevant. Have Lich Seed, I guess it's okay. But we don't care about the form that we are taking here. Alright, just so you are aware of it. The form doesn't matter. Okay, so we have a burn on Gyarados right now. It's actually pretty scary, but since we don't have anything to eat it, and we don't have anything over there as well, so I'm gonna transfer from Zigzagoon. We do have some berries because we keep winning, and we want to look for a Lumberry. Those are gonna remove burns and all of that jazz. Those are gonna be very useful. So if you have any eggs here, like any lucky egg or super lucky egg or whatever, you want to move them from Zigzagoon to Gyarados as soon as you get them. I've been looking to find one, but I don't get anything right now. We have some stuff that we can move, but it's definitely not the best here. So now what's gonna happen is next time we do an attack, we are gonna remove the burn, basically. Because we have those Lumberries, we don't actually care about poison or anything. Lumberries are very easy to find, and Lepa Berries as well. So don't hesitate to transfer them from your pickup Pokemon to your main Pokemon, right? We want to avoid using money for that conditions. No, we actually want to remove them. It's very important too. Now, what are we looking for exactly? It doesn't matter. We are looking for King's Rock, the Multilens, Wildlands, Amulet Coin, all those like red items, basically. We're not looking for anything specific. We don't really have anything to fuse together. We could, technically, but I'm probably not gonna fuse anything for a very long time. I'm just gonna stay with that team for now. Miss! Okay, well, it is what it is, right? It is what it is. So you want that EXP charm, right? It's gonna give you an EXP charm. You want that, so try to not skip if you can. Even if you die on your main Pokemon, it's okay. Don't, like, overreact. See if you can actually kill it with something else. It's definitely the play here. Okay, so now we need to heal before the paradox, so don't forget to heal, very important here. Don't reroll too much, it's too expensive at this point. We want to reroll at the very beginning when it's very cheap, but now it's not worth. Definitely, I'm gonna go for X defense. Depends what we get. Screamtail is actually not bad. I'm just gonna go for the curse if we can. We can, we die, but that's okay. He's cursed, and now I'm gonna go with... I guess we could go Cloyster, because gaining on Gyarados doesn't matter. I'm just gonna Water Shuriken to like remove the first bar. There you go. He's not gonna kill me. It's not happening ever. I'm doing a Rock Blast now. More damage, and we finish with Curse. There you go. That's how we do it. We are now level cap on Cloyster and on Gyarados once again. That's the goal here. But that's where I'm gonna stop today. So the goal was basically to explain to you how the early game works, how we make the team, what's important. Please tell me what you want to see. If you want to see this series, I can stop it right now. It doesn't matter for me. Just something I wanted to do. I wanted to play a flinch Pokemon. I have two endless series going on right now. I have another series that's coming up as well. So thank you guys for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.